Hello everyone. In this video, we will implement GrayWolf Optimizer in Python. So here, using GrayWolf Optimizer, we will help the robot to navigate in a 2D environment from starting point to goal point. So here we have 2D environment with multiple obstacles and we have static obstacles. So we are using here GrayWolf Optimizer to find out best and collision free environment for the robot to move from starting point to the destination. Done. And in previous video we already discussed everything about path planning in robotics, like we have different types of environment, challenges, application, and we also discussed different traditional methods, and we also compare different traditional methods with the meta heuristic optimizer. Then we decide which algorithms are better. So here we will use GrayWolf Optimizer for the robot path planning. So we will use here 2D environment. Then, and in this 2D environment, we will create multiple static obstacles. And using GrayWolf Optimizer, we will find out the best path for the robot, that is shortest and collision free. Then, to move from starting point to destination. And in the end, we will also discuss the limitations of this code and how we can improve it further. Done. So about this algorithm, we already discussed in previous videos. For more details, you can check these videos. Now let's start the implementation. First, we will import all the important libraries. So first, here we are using NumPy that we will use to perform numerical operations, like to handle arrays and for other mathematical function. Then we are using here matplotlib.pyplot as plt to visualize the final robot path and the obstacles. After that, we will initialize all the important parameters. So parameters, here we have algorithm parameters plus the problem parameter. So here we will initialize all important parameters of this algorithm. Then we will initialize the robot path planning parameters. First, we will initialize the population size. It means the total number of search agents we are using here in this algorithm. The total number of search agents means GrayWolf. Here you can initialize any number of search agents. After that, we will set the maximum iteration. So maximum number of iteration means how many iteration the algorithm will run, and after that it will display the best solution. Then we will set the dimension. Dimension, here we have 2D dimension. It means it is the dimension of search space. So here we have 2D environment. Done. Then we will set the search space boundary. So here we will set the search space boundary for the search agents. We will move the search agents only inside this search space. So set the boundary. So here, suppose we have x minimum 0 np dot array, then we have x minimum 0, x maximum 100, y minimum we have 0, y maximum we have 100. So we have 100 by 100 area. Now we will set the starting point. Now here we have the environment. Now in this environment, we will create the initial position for the robot. Now here we have the starting coordinates of the robot, means this is the starting position of the robot at coordinates 10, 10. Then this is the starting position of the robot. Now we will set the destination, means the goal position of the robot. Then means the target coordinate robot is trying to reach. Now we have this environment, starting position, target position. Now we will create obstacles. So here we will create 4 static obstacles. You can initialize any number of obstacles. So first, so we will create an array, and inside this set the coordinates of the static obstacle that the robot must avoid. So first obstacle we have at coordinate 30, 30, second 50, 50, third we have 70, 20, then 80, 80. Now we have all the obstacles. Now we will fix safe distance for the robot, means we will set the minimum distance the robot must maintain from the obstacles. Now suppose the safe distance we have 10. Now we will define our objective function. So using this function, we will reward the path that is closer to the goal. and we will penalize the proximity to obstacles. As in the previous video, we discussed that we will add the penalty to the path that is either closer to the obstacle or the path that collide with the obstacle. We will add the penalty to that path. So now we will define the function. So here, this function will calculate the fitness of given position. So using this function, we can calculate the fitness of any position done. So we have fitness function, then position. First we have distance to goal. So here we will use Euclidean distance to calculate how far the current position is from the goal. So here we are using this NumPy function to calculate how far the current position is from the goal. So position minus goal. Then we will set the penalty. Now we'll initialize the penalty value, it is 0. After that, for each obstacles, we will calculate the distance to the current position. Then, so here we will calculate distance to the current position. After that, we will add the penalty. First, we will check the if the distance is less than safe distance, then we will add the penalty. The closer it is means we will add the higher penalty to that path. So here, using this, we can add the penalty. After that, this function will return us the total cost, distance to goal plus penalty. Done. So here function is created. Now we will initialize the wolf position, means we will initialize the position of our search agents randomly. So randomly we will initialize the position of wolf within the boundaries of the search space. Here each wolf representing possible position or path. So alpha, beta, delta. So we have alpha position, beta position, delta position. So initially we will set the alpha position, that is the best position, to the starting position, while beta and delta are set to none. Then we have alpha score, beta score, delta score. This score, so we will set this score initially infinity. Then using this score, we will check the path quality for the best, that is alpha. Second best, we have beta. Third best, we have delta. Then we will store the best path and its fitness score. So here we will store the optimal path found, and we will store this for each iteration. Then we will start the main loop, and this algorithm will run up to maximum iteration, and it will search for the optimal path from the starting position to the goal while avoiding all the obstacles. After that, we will evaluate fitness for each wolf. So here, for each wolf in the population, we will calculate their fitness score using fitness function. So this function typically penalizes the path. So as we already discussed, using this function, we will penalize the path that are closer to the obstacles, and we will reward the path that is closer to the goal. Then we will update alpha, beta and delta. So here we will compare their fitness score. If any wolf fitness score is better than alpha score, then it become the new alpha. So here we will compare the fitness value, and accordingly we will compare all. Then we will store the best path and its score. After that, we will store the best path and its score. So here we will append the alpha position, that is the best position, to the best path, and alpha score to the best score. And after that, we will update the wolf position using alpha, beta and delta. So the position of the wolves are updated based on the position of three best wolf: alpha, beta, delta. So we will update the position, and we will calculate the distance between wolf and each of the best position. Then we have new candidate position based on alpha, beta, delta, x1, x2, x3. Then we will average the position. So final position will update for each wolf as the average of x1, x2, x3. This ensures the balance between exploration and exploitation, and the position is clipped. Then we will check the boundary. So now we will perform the visualization. So now we will clear the plots with plt.clf. For each iteration, we will perform this. Done. Now we create the plot for the wolf and the path for visualization. In the plot, first we have the starting point. It is green circle. You can see this is green circle. You can see the size 10. Then we have goal point. This is red circle. You can see, and the size for this 10. After this we have obstacle. This is black square and the size is 10. After this we will check if any best path exists, and in case the best path exists, we will plot this path with sign color. You can change this color. Here we are using sign. Then the line width we have 1.5. After this we will highlight the position of alpha wolf, that is the best position with the sign star. So we will create a star here for the best position. This size we have 12. After this we will set the plot title, display the current number of iterations and all. Now we will display the final output. Done. Final output and all the plots. So first we will display the best path found. So first we will print the best position found by the alpha wolf at the end of iteration. Then we will plot convergence curve that will show how best fitness score improves over time. Then we will create a final visualization and we will show starting point, goal point and all the obstacles and the best path found so far. You can see here, if best path is found, then we will show this and all the obstacles. Now we will run the code, and when you will run the code, you can see the best path found so far. Here you can see all the search agents, they are moving, and you can see this is the starting point and here we have end point, and you can see this is the best path created by the alpha position, and in the end all the search agents converge at a point. Then this is the convergence curve, and here we have the final path. You can see starting point, goal point, other obstacles. So here we added more obstacles. You can change here population size, number of iterations, then run the code. Each time you can see it will try to improve the path. Here now you can see now you can see this path is collision free. This path not collide with any obstacle, and here you can see this is shorter one than the previous. So after 100 iteration it will stop. You know how we have the final path, and this is collision free. So each time you will run this code, so each time you will run, it will try different path. Here you can see now, in the end, all the search agents will converge at a point. Done. So this is our final output. So here we added more obstacles. You can add. Plus, if you want to change the color, you can go here, and if you want to change the size, then here you can see 20 starting point, and end point is also 20. Then you can see the obstacle size was 50, and this is the current position of both. So search agent suppose now we have 15. Done. Run code. Now you can see when we increase the size of our obstacles, this collide here and here and then reach here. You can see now it is collision free. It not collide now with any obstacle this time. You can see here the best route it found, and it not collide with any obstacle, convergence curve, and this is our final path. Done. Little bit with this one, but at least it avoid them. Change the starting point. The line width, let's take it 3. Oh, you can see now this time it not collide with any obstacle, just little bit with this one. So this is the final path. Now we'll discuss the limitations and future improvements. First, you can see first limitation we have fixed parameter. So when here we have fixed parameter like population size is fixed. So manually we are changing, we can change the population size. Number of iterations is also fixed. And you can see the boundary, search space boundary, it is also fixed. So we have fixed parameters. It means sometimes as we are changing the starting point and the target point, so sometimes fixed parameters are not suitable for the different scenarios. Second, we have static obstacles. So we have to handle here static obstacles and they are fixed. So we have fixed obstacles, not moving one. So we can handle here only the static obstacles. It cannot be applied to the moving obstacles in the dynamic environment. Third, we have single objective fitness function that we created here. It is considering just the distance to the goal and the obstacle avoidance. So in real world, we have multiple objectives, like we have to save time, energy. We have to consider them also. Then what we can improve. So we can use different methods to dynamically adjust the parameters. And we can also improve this to handle moving obstacles in the dynamic environment. And we can modify the fitness function so that it can handle multiple objectives. Done. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below. And thanks for watching this video.